Toraph Moses again. We're going to do another session with Toraph Moses. And we're just going to ask true benevolent source and the people of the Toraph to monitor and safeguard this channel and transmission. We'd like to ask the elements of fire, Helios' sun, as well as the element of water, which is this beautiful ocean, surf the air, and the element of the earth, our earth mother, and the ether element, which is this body that I am inhabiting. And we will culminate and merge all these elements and create and manifest a protective shield, a shield against any spying parasites that like to spy and siphon auric energies. And we ask these energies to protect us while enduring our transmission and channel. So we're just going to start by introducing our tools. I have my Lumerian, my Amber, my Shungite Pebble, and my Selenite one. So those are the tools we'll be using. So I'm just going to call on any elemental being that would like to participate in this drawing session. If so, please allow us to grace your presence. And show us your heart space. Okay. So, are there any positive elementals that would like to participate? If so, show us your heart space. Okay. I got a couple of them. A couple of elementals showing me their heart space. Let me see if I can get an image. I see this crustacean folk. He has these little eyes. It's like this. If you're positive, please show me your heart space once again. Okay, one more time. If you're positive, show me your heart space. Okay. Oh, it's my crab friend. My crab friend came. Came back. I didn't finish my sentence. My phone just dropped. It has a nice crack on it. But thank God it still works. But this is not the same crab. This is something else. Yeah, so there's a lot of weird energies lately. I think something is brewing in the air. We can all feel it. This is a different type of being. It is a crustacean toad, but I thought it was my mantis, my crab friend, but this is not the crab friend. Before I continue this drawing even further, do you have a name that you would like to share us? I saw the colors green and the word worm. Is your name Green Worm? His name is GreenWood. Well, thank you, GreenWood, for revealing your name. So, he's an arthropod, kind of like one of those prehistoric arthropods, like the scorpion. I forgot what they're called, the scorpion something. Sea scorpions. And the sea scorpions are, they're just like, they were like the mother of like the sea, the horseshoe crabs. So these are their great ancestors. But these beings are different. So it has these humanoid appendages such as a hand and fingers. Oh, he's a council member. Are you in the opposing side or the for humanity side? He says he belongs to a council in one of the Atlantic Ocean Dome cities, underwater cities. I see it's like an emerald, like everything is light up like a emerald color, a jade color, a neon green. So this is like deep in the water. He says, yeah. Yeah. So GreenWood, so what is your stance with the council in terms of like... He says he's an advocate for a unified, balanced Earth. So right now they're just in a meeting, and they were eager to meet with me. Okay, since you're in a council right now, what are you guys discovering or debating? I see a rainbow in this dome, and I see emerald orbs and neon orbs flying around in this city. It's a beautiful space. The light is reflecting on the surface of the dome and all of the architecture. There's squid types, other crustacean types, and fish folk. They notice the pollution has started back up in the ocean. And they're trying to find ways to reach to the surface population in terms of our governmental leaders. Try to focus more on the ecology of the planet and to find solutions to have a better coexisting relationship. Okay, well thank you for that. There's a pig in here. Show me the rest of your body. So this being, how tall are you, GreenWood? 12 feet tall. However, his crest is an additional 4 to 5 feet tall. Long, sorry. 4 to 5 feet long. So I'll draw a profile of him. It is a masculine energy. So this is his profile. Okay, so this is just to give you an idea of how he looks. So GreenWood, do you have any do you have anything to say? In terms of a status quo. He's like, he will go over a few futures descriptors, I'm sorry. So like, this is underneath his crest. And they're like blotches, like green and orange and browns on here. And then also here, this is his mouth, but they're kind of like, it's covering like these kind of like jaws. So his carapace, this is what it's called, like crest or carapace, is 4 to 5 feet long. He has big bulging eyes, similar to like the mantis or dragonflies. And then here is this emerald green. And his antenna is orange. And then the top of the crescent, it's like a brown, green, and blue. So it's a blend of those colors. He looks like he would, like, if you would see him, he would look like a giant horseshoe crab / centipede. But, you know, he does have this humanoid body. And he's also telling me another feature where he can condense himself. So, I know that was an awful drawing of your carapace, but I'll just draw one from the top view. So they kind of look like a trilobite from the top. He said that they're descendants of the trilobites. They are trilobites, but they're more an evolved form of trilobite. Oh, okay. Yeah, so they can like condense themselves to hide their legs, and they can flatten themselves on the sea floor. So when you look at it from the top, they look like trilobites or some type of crab. Okay, so they have two arms, two legs. This is their chest, their abdomen. And then these are just more ridges, like exo armor or exoskeleton armor in the back. They go throughout the back here, like this. They're highly intelligent. Do you have any clothes? He has a sash. So a sash like this. And then his sash goes here. What color are your sash colors? He says they represent a council member. And let me just make sure, I want to audit this being known as Toraph Moses. And this being as GreenWood have true benevolent source audit us to make sure that and ensure we provide accurate, genuine information for our highest good and our highest good only. So the colors, oh, it's the same thing. The colors here is green, like an emerald green. and blue mixed with orange. Okay, that's so cool. So you're a council member. And you're for I don't want to say they're for humans because it's bigger than this. It's not only the humans that are affected with what goes on the planet Earth. Every inhabitant on and off planet and in the inner Earth and in the oceans. So what they represent is just like if you would say a balance, to balance out the playing field, to find solutions to balance the playing field. So do you have anything else to say to humanity in terms of any advice that you'd like to give humankind during this great time of transition? He says their ocean waves are now turbulent. There's some orbs flying around him. It's like these green neon orbs. And he says that we must calm the turbulence within each of us. Okay. Well, thank you so much for your wisdom. And we will definitely update a better drawing of this at a later time. Thank you, GreenWood, for sharing your thoughts and sharing you. Bye.